Rapunzel. Once upon a time, a poor man and his wife were going to have a baby. They had a little window at the back of their house from which they could see the most wonderful garden full of herbs and vegetables. There was just one problem. The garden belonged to a witch. One day, the woman was standing by the window, looking out at the vegetable garden. She hadn't had anything nice to eat in days and felt very hungry. She saw some delicious looking lettuce growing in one of the vegetable patches and she longed to try some. "If I don't get any of that lovely lettuce, I think I might die," said the woman to her husband. The woman's husband loved her very much, so that evening he climbed over the wall into the witch's garden and pulled a handful of lettuce leaves from the ground. The wife ate them happily. The trouble was that she enjoyed the lettuce so much she wanted more. So the next night, the husband once again climbed the wall into the garden. Unfortunately, he came face to face with the witch. The witch was angry. "How dare you come into my garden and steal my vegetables?" she shouted at the poor man. "I'll make you pay for this." The poor man was terrified. "Please," he said to the witch, "I'm very sorry, but my wife and I don't have a lot of money and often go hungry. My wife saw your lovely lettuce from the window and just had to have some. She wanted it so much that she might die without it. I'm very sorry." "Fair enough," replied the witch. "You may take as much as you want, but on one condition. When your wife has her baby, you must give the child to me." The man was frightened and, without stopping to think about what he was doing, agreed to the witch's demands and ran quickly out of the garden. Not long after, the baby was born. It was a little girl, and the couple called her Rapunzel. The witch came to the couple's house and took the baby away. Rapunzel grew up to be a kind and beautiful child. When she was 12 years old, the witch took her to a tall tower in the middle of a forest and locked her up. The tower had no stairs or doors. There were no windows except for a little one right at the very top. When the old witch wanted to go inside, she would stand at the bottom and shout, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair." Rapunzel's hair was long and golden. When she heard the witch's voice, she would drop her hair out of the little window and it would drop down to the ground. The witch would then climb up it like a rope until she reached the top of the tower. Rapunzel felt very lonely all alone in the tower. To pass the time, she would sing to herself. She had a beautiful voice. One day, a prince was riding through the forest and passed the tower. He heard Rapunzel's delightful singing and stood still to listen. He wanted to climb up to her, but he could not find a way inside. Every day after that, the prince would ride out to the forest and listen to Rapunzel sing. One day, when he was standing hidden amongst the trees, he saw the witch arrive at the tower and saw how she looked up to the top and cried, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair." Then Rapunzel's golden hair tumbled down the side of the tower and the witch climbed up. The prince rode home. But the next evening, as darkness began to fall, he went back to the tower and, just as he had heard the witch do, he shouted up, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair." Immediately the hair tumbled down and the prince climbed up to the little room at the top of the tower. At first, Rapunzel was frightened to see a stranger standing there. But the prince began to tell her all about how he would ride out to the forest every day just to listen to her sing. They were soon chatting away like old friends, and Rapunzel found herself falling in love with the kind and charming prince. When the prince asked Rapunzel to marry him, she told him straight away that she would. Although happy at the thought of marrying the prince, Rapunzel also felt extremely sad. She had no way of leaving the tower. Then she had an idea. She asked the prince to bring a piece of silk with him each time he came to visit. Rapunzel would weave the silk together until she had made a ladder long enough to climb down. Then she would be free to escape the tower and marry the prince. They agreed that the prince should come every evening to avoid meeting the witch, who visited Rapunzel in the daytime. One day, when the witch had climbed Rapunzel's hair and threw the little window into the tower, Rapunzel, without thinking, said, "Old woman, you are so much heavier than the prince when you climb up." Upon hearing this, the witch got angry. "You wicked child," she spat, "you have deceived me. I thought you were all alone in this tower, and now I find that you've had a visitor without my knowledge." Angrily, the witch reached for a pair of scissors and snipped through Rapunzel's hair, leaving the long golden locks on the floor. Then she grabbed Rapunzel and took her deep into the forest, leaving her there alone. The witch then returned to the tower and fastened Rapunzel's golden hair onto a hook next to the little window. When the prince came by and called, "Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair," the witch threw the long hair out of the window and the prince came up. When the prince reached the little window, he was shocked to find the witch standing there alone, his dear Rapunzel nowhere to be seen. "Ha!" sneered the witch. "You expected to find your little princess, didn't you? Well, she's gone, banished into the woods where you'll never find her again." With that, the witch pushed the prince hard and he fell to the ground, landing in a pile of spiky thorn bushes. The thorns scratched the prince's eyes, leaving him blind. Weeks went by and the poor prince spent his days wandering miserably around the woods, eating roots and berries and crying over the loss of his sweet Rapunzel. One day, the prince heard a voice. Someone was singing. Immediately he stopped sobbing and listened. He recognized that voice. It was a voice so sweet and dear to him that he could never forget it. "Rapunzel, Rapunzel," he shouted in hope. The next moment, Rapunzel was next to him, hugging him with all her might and crying tears of joy. Two of her tears fell onto the prince's eyes, and instantly he was able to see again. The prince took Rapunzel back to his kingdom, where they were welcomed with great joy, and they lived there happily for many years to come.